For as long as we can remember, humans have been drawn to the unknown, and the night sky has been a constant source of wonder. The allure of distant worlds and the thrill of exploring the stars have driven us to dream big. Movies like Interstellar have shown us what could be possible with the use of wormholes and advanced propulsion systems like hyperdrives, gravitational time dilation, and cryogenic hibernation. But while these stories inspire us, the reality is that interstellar travel remains a distant dream, and the technology to make it happen is still purely theoretical. Take for instance Proxima Centauri, our closest neighboring star, is a staggering 266,000 times farther away from us than the Sun. To put that in perspective, it's 103 million times farther away than the Moon. Even light, which travels at the fastest speed possible, will take 4.3 years to reach us from Proxima Centauri. And yet, we remain steadfast in our belief that our current technology is merely a temporary obstacle. As we gaze up at the starry night sky, it's hard to comprehend the unfathomable distances between stars. Believe me, we will never travel among the stars. But if you doubt this, then join me on this fascinating journey as we ponder and explore the possibilities of traversing the vast distances between star systems. It was Enrico Fermi who first asked the haunting words, "Where is everybody?" Or more specifically, "Why haven't we encountered any signs of intelligent extraterrestrial life?" With billions of planets out there, it's hard to believe that we're the only ones who made it. So what's going on? Are we really the first to overcome some huge evolutionary hurdles? Various hypotheses have been put forth to explain the Fermi Paradox, from the possibility of self-destruction among technological societies to the notion that conditions for intelligent life may be exceedingly rare. But maybe the real answer to the paradox has been overlooked because it's a rather boring one. The answer may simply be that the massive distances between star systems present daunting challenges that even the most sophisticated civilization may struggle to overcome. The energy and resources required to transport living beings across these immense voids could be so exorbitant that it simply may not be worth the effort for any civilization, no matter how advanced. Now, before we explore the possibilities of traversing the vast distances between star systems, let us first ponder this question. Is humanity doomed to remain confined within the boundaries of our solar system, forever bound to the gravitational chains of our celestial home? To figure this out, let's do a little thought experiment. Our goal is to design the most plausible crewed interstellar mission. We'll send a starship to Proxima Centauri, aiming to get there in a generation and keep the crew alive. The ship will use a propulsion system that can reach 20% of the speed of light. But there's a problem. At that speed, even tiny specks of space dust can destroy the ship. At 20% light speed, hitting a dust grain just 1 millimeter wide would deliver millions of joules of energy, instantly vaporizing the ship. So, do we even make it out of our own solar system? Probably not. There's a lot of leftover debris from the formation of our planets, and the chances of hitting something are too high. Luckily, the farther we get from the Sun, the fewer of these tiny meteoroids there are. Maybe we can push straight up out of the solar system to avoid the dense stuff in the Earth's orbit and use lasers from Earth to clear a path ahead of us. Next, we would head towards Proxima Centauri and see how far we can go without being destroyed. To understand this, let's examine the interstellar medium. It is 99% gas by mass and 1% tiny dust grains. The gas is about 90% hydrogen, with most of the rest being helium and traces of heavier elements. The average gas density in the Milky Way disk is about 1 atom per cubic centimeter. But our Sun is in an under-dense region called the local bubble, likely created by a vast supernova. Here, the density is about 1 atom per 10 cubic centimeters. The dust in space consists of silicate and carbonaceous molecules that have clumped together into grains. These elements are formed in the cores of massive stars and are ejected in supernovae or stellar winds. The grains usually range from a tenth to a few tenths of a micrometer across. Larger grains are extremely rare outside planetary systems, making the chance of a single grain destroying our ship negligible. The components of interstellar space, atoms, molecules, and dust grains, coalesce to form larger structures. The majority of these grains measure between a tenth to a few tenths of a micrometer across. Larger grains are exceedingly rare beyond planetary systems, to the point that the possibility of a single grain destroying a spacecraft can be reasonably disregarded. The smaller grains themselves are quite sparse, with approximately 1 grain per 100 meter cube of volume. While both the gas and dust in interstellar space are diffuse, the vast distances involved mean a spacecraft will still encounter a substantial amount of this material. However, individual impacts are unlikely to destroy the vessel. Consider the example of a satellite or a meteoroid entering Earth's atmosphere. These objects begin to burn up almost immediately upon reaching the upper layers, where the air density is only a millionth that of sea level. This is because they travel at several to several tens of kilometers per second, impacting air molecules with tremendous kinetic energy that is then deposited into the falling object, often destroying it before reaching the ground. Interstellar space is far less dense than the upper atmosphere, by a factor of around 10 to the power of 16. But a spacecraft traveling at 0.2 c or 20% of the speed of light will be moving approximately 10,000 times faster than a re-entering low Earth orbit satellite. The kinetic energy deposited by each particle impact is therefore greatly reduced compared to the atmospheric re-entry by around a billion times. With moderate shielding and heat dissipation, the spacecraft may be able to withstand this bombardment. But a new challenge arises. At these extreme velocities, even a single impacting atom or molecule can cause damage. The cumulative effect of these countless minor impacts must be carefully considered. A 2016 paper by Thiem Huang and colleagues examined the effects of individual particle impacts during high-speed interstellar travel. They found that the lighter elements like hydrogen and helium don't really cause lasting damage. They mainly just deposit heat. However, heavier elements like oxygen and iron can leave permanent scars on the spacecraft. In fact, Huang's team calculated that traveling to Proxima Centauri at 20% the speed of light would result in the complete vaporization of the forward hull of the ship. That's a pretty dramatic impact. In another 2006 paper, Oleg Semyonov looked at the radiation levels an inadequately shielded crew would face at relativistic speeds. He found that the levels would be comparable to the core of a nuclear reactor. Needless to say, that level of radiation exposure would be instantly lethal for any living organism aboard. So there is no debate about the fact that high-speed interstellar travel will pose several major challenges when it comes to protecting the spacecraft and its crew from the intense impacts and radiation. It's a tough engineering challenge that would need to be solved before attempting such a journey. Outside our thought experiment, there are several other important issues to consider. If we were to embark on an experiment like this in 2024, there are several key considerations to keep in mind. For starters, Proxima Centauri is about 4.3 light-years away. Even with our fastest technology, similar to the Parker Solar Probe, a generation starship would take approximately 7,197 years to reach our closest neighbor. This means the journey would span around 100 generations, with the initial voyagers and their descendants living and dying in transit, with subsequent generations born into the journey without a choice. The concept of a generation ship raises profound ethical questions. Would it be possible to find volunteers willing to commit not just their own lives, but those of their descendants to a mission from which they would never see the outcome? The fascination with Mars colonization suggests that humans are willing to embark on one-way journeys, and the allure of pioneering new frontiers might be enough to inspire volunteers for such a daring odyssey. Upon arrival at the Alpha Centauri system, the astronauts would face two potential realities. In the first scenario, they'd discover that the planets within the system are inhospitable to life as we know it, rendering their monumental journey a stark lesson in the unpredictability of cosmic exploration. In the second scenario, they'd find that humans have already reached and colonized the planets, thanks to technological advancements made back on Earth during the starship's lengthy voyage. Yes, human curiosity won't wait for them. Hey guys, just a moment before we continue. Be sure to join the Insane Curiosity channel. Click on the bell, you'll help us to make products of even higher quality. How close are we to becoming a space-faring civilization? When we consider the sheer scale of the Milky Way, stretching across 100,000 light years, we begin to grasp the enormity of interstellar travel. Breaking it down, we get approximately 20,000 potential destinations across the galaxy, each separated by about 5 light years. If we were to travel to each of these points, the fastest probe we have today would take a staggering 169 million years to traverse the galaxy just once. And that's without stopping to explore or change course along the way. This mind-boggling feature highlights the colossal challenge of interstellar travel. The vast distances between stars and galaxies underscore the need for significant breakthroughs in propulsion technology, energy generation, and our understanding of space-time itself. If we're to become a space-faring civilization, we need a leap in innovation and imagination to bridge the cosmic distances between stars. However, there's a glimmer of hope. Simulations by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory suggest that with generational ships traveling at speeds of up to 500 kilometers per second, it might take around 90 million years to colonize significant portions of the galaxy. The concept of von Neumann probes, self-replicating spacecraft that could explore and colonize distant star systems, presents another intriguing avenue for galactic colonization. When we finally figure out how to build a spaceship that can survive all the hurdles of interstellar travel, there's still one major issue that can't be solved: time dilation. It would create a permanent divide between the spaceship and its planet of origin. Imagine leaving your family, friends, and everything you know behind, never to see them again. And when you finally return, you'll find a society that's completely changed. It's not just about the personal cost. This kind of travel would also make it impossible for interstellar organizations like the United Federation of Planets to exist. These organizations rely on trade and cultural exchanges between different civilizations, which wouldn't be possible with the time it takes to travel between stars. Think about it. Would a company send goods to the other side of the galaxy knowing they'd never hear back from the spaceship they sent them with? It's a one-way ticket to nowhere. In essence, any spaceship that ventures into the realm of Einstein's theory of relativity becomes its own isolated world, cut off from the past and its homeland. Who would truly be interested in that? Despite our dreams of becoming a space-faring civilization, the reality of interstellar travel remains just beyond our reach, for now, at least. But this only spurs us in our quest to understand and eventually traverse the vast expanse of our galaxy and beyond. Are you optimistic that we will travel through the stars in the near future? Do you think the colonization of other star systems holds any value? Feel free to leave your answers in the comments below. If you liked the video, then you should check out the one on your screen. This is a fascinating tale about the brightest stars in the universe. Thanks for watching.